Hey, what's up guys, Damian here with another noob raping video, as always, owning and raping those little noobs. And here I am playing Crossout because I had a report of a new noob specimen type, the wasteland type of noob. Yes, that's right, the wasteland types of noob. Look at them. Now the wasteland types of noobs, they prefer moving around in vehicles with guns and stuff like that. And of course we need the noob hunter to teach them where they belong. Now this game is in fact a very fun and very creative game, because you get to create your own vehicle and decide how you want it to perform, and you need to, you know, to put the guns on the vehicle in strategic location so that the enemy won't be able to shoot off your guns and stuff like that. And that will be very unfortunate, because you know the noobs, if they manage to do that, you are just as good as dead. And of course I have some complaints about the game. It's not a 100% perfect game, and it is free to play though. You can pay to buy stuff, but it's not necessarily pay to win. It's more likely pay to progress, to be honest. But there are still some newbie stuff going on about this game, and I will explain to you what I mean. Now you can see me playing here with this is my very first Canon build. Of course it's not a perfect build, because in the beginning you don't have all the parts you want to make some sort of super vehicle, or a super tank, or a badass APC, or an SUV that you dream of. But you get those by grinding, of course. You know, all free-to-play games involve grinding, and that's where it comes to the pay factor. I mean, you can pay to progress, and sometimes it can be pay to win, because you can spend a lot of money and buy the end game stuff. And then, you know, obviously the end game stuff are better than the average stuff. But here's the thing, here's my complaint, it's the matchmaking. Now, in order to get match made in whatever match you wanna play, there is a thing that that's called the power score of the vehicle. And that depends on how you build your vehicle, how many parts, how many weapons, and what's the value of the parts and the weapons. And that's how the power score of your vehicle is determined. And look at this, I'm sniping the noobs. And yes, you can snipe the noobs with the cannons, or a railgun that exists in the game. And now, like I was saying, the power score is sometimes the matchmaking can put you in matches with the players of equal power score than you, so in that case the match is fair. And but most of the times guys, you get in matches where the guys, the enemy guys, or sometimes even in your own team, have much more higher power score than you. And to give you an example, I was I remember once I was a 4000 power score, and I was being matchmade in games with players of 5000 power score, and even higher than that, up to 6000 even. And that was completely unbalanced for me, because I had a 4000, they had 5000 plus. And now if they have 200 or 300, that's not a bigger deal, but 5000, stuff like that, I mean, that's crazy. And this is the only thing that really is the issue of this game, and they need to fix that. And now I can understand that not all the players of the same power score about to play in the same time of the day. I mean, okay, that's understandable, but and you don't always get even matches. But still, that doesn't necessarily mean that you are outgunned all the time. So I've beaten players of higher power scores, and of course, you know, not because I'm the noob hunter and I teach the noobs a lesson, and you know, all these noobs, they are of course no comparison to me. But sometimes, you know, the noobs, they invest so heavily in armor and they don't get good guns. And if they get their guns destroyed, then I mean, they're just sitting ducks, and they are very easy to kill. And of course, we have the now. This is the another thing that really destroys this game. And you can get stuff like automatic turrets and drones. You know, flying drones with rocket launchers, with machine guns. Stationary turrets and like I said, automatic machine guns that you mount on your vehicle and they auto-target the enemies for you. And I mean, come on, what is this, guys? I mean, these are noob-friendly stuff. I mean, I don't know why they put those things into the game, and because, you know, the noob can just simply drive by you, and if they have the automatic turret or the flying drones, they can do the work for him. And I mean, what is the player is doing? And he's doing nothing. That's a completely noobish loadout to have here in this game, in my opinion. And now this build is my you know, my first machine gun build, and of course it's not perfect, as you can see right here. It looks kind of goofy, because you, like I said, you don't get all the parts you want from the beginning. You need to grind. And look at the noobs. Here I am with actually four noobs, and I will manage to get all of them because I am maneuverable. I'm shooting with my machine guns all the time, and I have a relatively balanced vehicle. Look at the noobs. They try to get me, but of course, you know, the tiny little noobs ain't got shit on the noob hunter. That's how tiny they are. Look at him. Look at the noobs. Yes, guys. So this game is a very fun game in terms of creativity, because, you know, like I said, you get to build your own vehicle, and then you get to test it out against both in PvE and PvP. As you see right here, the noobs getting on, getting raped. But the thing is that the matchmaking, sometimes, like I said, you can get matchmade with players that are of much higher power score than you, and you lose the game, and then you wonder what went wrong. I mean, was it my build that was wrong? Was it my team that was terrible? I mean, was it me myself that didn't handle the situation well? And this is no guys, that's not always it. I mean, that's hardly it. I mean, it's the power scores. Players with power scores, they will just beat you. That's that's the reality about this game. If they have, of course, much more higher power score than you, they generally have the odds with them. Oh, of course, you can see me owning and raping those tiny little noobs, winning matches one after another. And teamwork is also another a big aspect of this game. You need to have good teammates, otherwise, if you have teammates like the noobs that I mentioned before, you know, with stuff that require no skill, or you know, the that they don't know how to play, how to move inside the match, and or they just go rushing in and they come across, you know, five enemy vehicles only to get get raped. I mean, you need to rely on your team as well. And if your team is bad and they suck, if they are noobs, if they are complete noobs, that will have an effect on you as well, because okay, sometimes you can't just destroy all the enemy targets by yourself. I mean, you need to be very skilled to destroy their machine guns, to destroy their weapons in general. Only then you have a chance. Look at them. I'm ruining all these noobs. Look at this. Four noobs in a row. And that was because, guys, my teammates were distracting them. They were also shooting them, and I got the kills. And this is how you play this game, guys. You need to rely on your team, you need to rely on your skill, and you need to have a good build vehicle. But anyways, thanks for watching this video, guys, and remember, keep on raping those little noobs!